Lord. Prepare the way of the Lord. Prepare the way of the Lord.
They tell me that it's going to be 100 today, or more. Oh well, praise the Lord. You know, I was kind of looking at the devotional and I was thinking about something that occurred today already. And it was interesting because in dealing with internet ministry, especially dealing with like Facebook or Twitter or some other instant response type of venue, you get a lot of people who are wrapped up emotionally on the very words that they read and the things that they say or type in this case, and get very reactive without thinking through what they're doing in order to be active in the Spirit of God. In other words, they're not moving with what God says to do, they're reacting to what the circumstances dictate to them. A person just recently posted something that was very, very offensive. It showed one man killing some other person. And I commented on that. I said, you shouldn't post that on the internet. I said, not only that, you know, I have to report it because it's violent in nature. It promotes violence. It is shocking to some people. It's against good conscience. In journalism, it would be said to be, you know, of the type that you would not post to the general public. And so I mentioned that and took a lot of heat and a lot of flack for being quote unquote judgmental or, you know, critical and all that kind of stuff. But the person immediately removed the post, the picture anyways. The post was about, you know, whatever they want with the picture, that they wanted to promote their cause. And while I may have agreed with their cause, the way that they were doing it was wrong by trying to use shock jock techniques from the world in order to convince people to look at their article, which didn't have anything to do with the picture, really. And they wanted to promote hate and reaction to a certain ethnic group rather than try to share the gospel. And so I commented on that, you know, and mentioned that, you know, that's not what we're all about. And sure enough, I was quote unquote judging. Well, one of the things that you do when you see things, you don't treat the person as though they were the cause. They're usually innocent of what they're doing. They're just fleshy or blowing it at some point in time. So you don't hate anyone, you don't choose to get involved in that part, but you do confront lots of times issues that are not the person, but the action. And so it's okay to confront an action as opposed to confronting the person. Oftentimes I get in an argument with my wife. I mean, often. Because we do have differences of opinion at times. And so we get in an argument. And when we do, me being the elder Christian, so to speak, I listen to every word she says, which, first of all, she hates that part. because first of all, I'm paying attention to her, and she doesn't like that. She has more of tendencies, because she works around men and she's been raised among men, that she has kind of like a manly attitude, you know, and I've been raised around a lot of varieties of different perspectives, so I kind of have accrued some skills along the way. So I listen to every word she says, and for the most part, in an argument, if it gets heated, I don't use it against her, but, you know, sometimes I'm aware of her contradictions by hearing every word she says. But the reason why I do, and I mentioned to her afterwards, and she hates lectures or teachings or what we call discussions, you know, and she calls it a lecture, is I listen to every word she says because I'm wondering if I'm at fault. You know, is that God? Are you trying to tell me something through my wife? You know, and I pay attention to what she says, and then afterwards, when I'm alone, I actually rehearse what went on in my mind, because I'm trying to learn from the experience, and part of that drives her crazy. Because in reality, I do learn from it. I learned not to do that again. No, I'm kidding. But the point being is that what people say and what they do, I pay attention to. I listen, and I immediately take it to the Lord in prayer. I take it to God and ask Him to show me if this is wrong in my life or if this is applicable to myself. Because I do believe that all individual circumstances of your life, every detail has been set aside or ordained by God Himself. He knows the very number of the hairs on your head. So if He knows that, how can there be any detail that He's not aware of that you're going through? And so, a lot of times people, in reacting to if I do something on the internet, react in a negative way, big time, because they have no clue or no concept the direction that I'm going. And as they proceed through the posts, they'll see that I'm turning them and myself back to God. I'll always bring up Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 for them to trust in the Lord with all their heart, lean not into their own understanding, but in all their ways acknowledge Jesus, and He'll direct their path. So I'm always telling them to, hey, look, if you're right, just tell me you prayed about it. Tell me that God told you to post it. Tell me that God told you to do it. And most of the time, no one will say that. I've never run into anyone who has posted something so blatantly, obviously not Christian, that they come back and tell me, oh yeah, God told them to do it. I just ask them that bluntly, because when I post something, I tell them, yes, I prayed about it and God told me to do it. Now take it up with Him. If it's wrong, then God will tell me. If it's right, then God will bless me. If not, then God's going to use it as a circumstance to teach me in some way. So I treat that very seriously when it comes to ministry, because I do believe that every idle word, and I'm guilty as you are of idle words, but we are accountable for every word spoken and every idle word and token of our attitudes and actions that we extend ourselves towards, whether that be in, you know, flipping fingers or checking attitudes or, you know, giving off wrong impressions in some ways. Now, I don't always go way out of my way in order to rectify all situations, but as much as possible, I try to share up to a point with a person and then let them, if they want to be mad at me, then great, be mad at me. But stop doing whatever it was that was wrong in their actions. And praise the Lord, you know, in today's circumstance that I ran into, they removed the offensive picture, you know, because they kind of knew I was guilty, you know, and they knew that, you know, and God told me they knew that, and I'm just kind of like, I was complimenting them on that. But, you know, by that time, of course, people are reactive and don't usually react in a positive way, which in a way, we ought to really act and consider that it would be positive if someone would come to us and challenge us, because then we can look at it and say, well, is that true? And I've asked, you know, people, and then people have said, you know, well, you know, you need prayer, buddy. And I admitted to them, I said, yeah, I always need prayer. I'll accept it. You know, whatever God tells you, you know, great, praise the Lord, then do it. You know, if God's telling you to do this, do that. Go ahead. You know, I'll just keep doing what I'm doing, you know, and if I'm wrong, He'll tell me. If I'm right, He'll tell me. So, often, sadly, you see sometimes confrontation that isn't meant to be positive, but people will criticize rather than confront. And it's a very touchy subject when you come into the area of judgment, because if you are judging, you're wrong. Because as a person, you can't judge according to the flesh. you could only do what you're supposed to do according to the things of the Spirit. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things would be added unto you. The day shall declare it. Judge nothing before the time, until the Lord come, who both will bring to light the hidden things of darkness, and will make manifest the counsels of the heart. Then shall every man have praise of God. See, a lot of times, some people, even though they may do the wrong thing, may have the right attitude. And so sometimes they may do it innocently, and God will reveal that in his time. Other times, people may have the right cause, they think, but the attitude was wrong, and because it was the wrong attitude of the heart, then God will reveal that in his time, not in ours. And so it says, don't judge anything before it's time that God reveals it, because except the Lord reveal it, there's no way of knowing it. Only God can show what was going on the inside, where we can only observe what we see on the outside. Why dost thou judge thy brother, or why dost thou set not thy brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of Christ. So then, every one of us shall give an account of himself to God. Let us not therefore judge one another any more. I always consider that challenging, because people want to judge. People want to criticize. People want to correct. People want to make instruction. And when you are a communicator, it is a challenge to walk the fine line between confrontation, communication, and cooperation. Oftentimes, most people don't want to cooperate, because when they communicate, they're always about confrontation. They are confronting type people. They want confrontation. And when they do receive it back, they react in a negative way, causing argumentation rather than communication. And the reality is, if you can bring about communication to the cooperation of both parties involved, praise the Lord. If not, sometimes what I do more than anything else is I expect the reader to be able to evaluate by way of his spirit at the right time in the right place, looking at the words that are said and then saying to themselves, you know, I think I agree with that, as God leads them. Now they may say, I think I disagree with that, and as the Lord leads them, then they should do. So a lot of times in places where I see that kind of confrontation, where you know that the Lord is telling you to say something, don't be surprised about the results, because if you're worried about results, then you're judging. If you're not concerned about the results and you're just doing according to what God tells you to do at the time of each individual point, then just do it as he says. But be mindful of the fact that it may not be with the results that you want, but the results that he wants to accomplish. God shall judge the secrets of men by Jesus Christ. The Father judges no man, but has committed all judgment unto the Son, and has given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of Man. I see so often people tell me that Jesus has given, you know, us the responsibility as well as accountability to judge. And I can't go there. I have to stick with what he said, judge not, lest you be judged, for with what measure you judge, you shall be judged. I would rather cooperate to open up the doors of communication in some types of confrontation, where in care confrontation, I care enough to be made the fool that they can enjoy their one-uppance if in fact they get the point across of what may be an action that's causing detriment to what they're doing in their ministry or in their life or in the lives of other people around them. And if that be the case, then let me be a doormat. Stomp on me, you know, romp on me, chomp on me, you know. Go ahead, you know. Praise the Lord. Sometimes you have to be wrong in order for God to be right. The great, the mighty God, the Lord of hosts is his name, great in counsel and mighty in work. For thine eyes are open upon all the ways of the sons of men, to give everyone according to his ways and according to the fruit of his doings. We reap what we sow. I am always challenged by that, and I always look to trying to produce, even in my plants, in my garden, better fruit. I may have to cut off branches at times. I may grow like crazy at times and extend outward and then realize I've gone too far and pull back. But we all must give an accounting to the Lord, so we need to really have ourselves open to an accounting to each other, as well as a responsibility to examine ourselves. And when we examine ourselves, we should do it in light of what God is telling us to do and God requires of us to do, improving His ministry in us as He works through us to the accomplishment of the love of God being shed abroad in the hearts of many, that they might see Jesus and come to salvation. It should always be about God and not about ourselves. It should always be pointing to Jesus and not about the issue. It should always be reflecting back to salvation and not condemnation, especially of the saints that are seeking to do God's will in the best way they know how, even though they may need forgiveness, for they know not what they're doing.
Save the people, O God of mercy, when the people, Lord, the people, not thrones and crowns, but men, flowers of thy heart, O God, are they? Let them not pass like weeds away, their heritage, a sunless day. God save the people. Shall crime bring crime forever, strengthening still the strong? Is it thy will, O Father, that men shall toil for wrong? Oh, now say thy mountains, now say thy skies, man's clouded sun shall brightly rise, and songs be heard instead of sighs. God save the people. Thank you.